There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle and makes his home. So carry your candle, run to the darkness.
Good evening and welcome to Light the Night by Candlelight. Pastor Steve and I'm Sandy West, would like to welcome you here to worship in this quiet moment outside here just a couple of days before Christmas.
It is good to be here and to be together for Light the Night. I'm Pastor Steve, and with me, you met Sandy already, I have Father Robert, the pastor at St. Luke's Episcopal Church, and we have Connie and Evan, their neighbors here, and we have Lynn and Kenny, and we have Sarah Margaret and her dad, Russ, and we're gathered here. They live in our neighborhood, just practically walking distance or quick drive. And we're lighting the night by candlelight. Thank you for joining us tonight. Russ is going to share the scripture.
Reading from Luke 2:25. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And this man was righteous and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel. And the Holy Spirit was upon him. And it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. And he came in the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him according to the custom of the law, he took him up in his arms and blessed God and said, Lord, now you are letting your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation that you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people, Israel. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Russ. And thanks to all of you for coming and joining us for Light the Night. The last few weeks, we've been talking about themes of light. In the scripture, when I first set out to do this, I didn't realize I was going to have to make choices because there's so many scripture. We looked at the words of Jesus himself. We've looked at the words of John the Baptist. We've looked at the theology of John the gospel writer, these image of light. Tonight, I thought we could turn for a few moments to the gospel of Luke, my favorite gospel to read during the Christmas holiday. I just love it because Luke is the one that tells us about the manger. Luke is the one that tells us about the shepherds and things like that. Luke also has these wonderful, they're called canticles. They are what I call the original Christmas carols. The first singers who saw the bigger themes of what God was doing through the coming of Christ. And somebody just passed by. So I hope you could hear what I just said. But they saw the bigger themes of what God was doing in the world to bring truth and justice to the world through the coming of Christ. And one of these canticles is what Russ just read. When the baby Jesus was brought to the temple for his circumcision a few days later, the Holy Spirit had placed a longing and a searching in the hearts of two people, Anna and Simeon, who are waiting there. They've been hanging around the temple, longing for the redemption of Israel. Hi, neighbor. How you doing? It's good to see you. Busy street tonight. And they were searching for the Messiah, and they both recognized that Jesus was the one they'd been waiting for. They recognized immediately who Jesus was. And Simeon sang this song as he held Jesus in the baby Jesus in his arms. And he talked about how he was a light for the revelation to the Gentiles. Wow, that describes the whole arc of the book of Acts, in which Christianity became this new and amazing worldwide faith. It also describes all the Old Testament longing, and what did Jews have to do with Gentiles? I mean, they were unclean. They were those other people in their rawest of emotions. Yet there's this messianic hope throughout the Old Testament, the longing for the light to the Gentiles. It was all over the book of Isaiah. What an amazing moment where Simeon brought that into his song as he looked at this baby Jesus who had been born in a manger. This new community was going to be created. It was not one race. It was not one people. And for us still, this holy child is not just for my kind of people. God has something bigger in mind. Years ago, I was having breakfast with another pastor of a different faith years ago, and I remember sitting at breakfast for this moment in my life that just clarified my theology, because he said something to the effect of, you know, before Jesus came, anybody could go to heaven. You didn't have to do anything to get to heaven, but then once Jesus came, you had to XYZ to go to heaven, and the way he said it didn't sound right, and I said, you know, it sounds like to me you're saying that Jesus closed the door of salvation. And he said, yes, he did. And I sat back in my chair and I said, well, that's exactly the opposite of what I think. I think Jesus blew the door open. He did blow the door open. He was a light to the Gentiles. This baby blows the door wide open. You don't have to be like me to be my brother and sister or sister in Christ, because there's something new. God is doing something new with a new community. And the light of Christ was the moment that light shined in the darkness, and the darkness will never overcome it. So let him blow open the door of your heart and have a very wonderful Christmas. I've asked a couple of people, I think Connie and Russ, are going to come back, and they're going to lead us in a Christmas carol.
Tonight, let's sing Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
And now Robert Fowler is going to come lead us in our closing prayer.
If you'll pray with me. Gracious Heavenly Father, here we are on this eve of Christmas Eve. We have prepared our hearts for the coming of the Christ child during this season of Advent, and now we're on the cusp of the light coming into our lives once again. We pray for all of those who may be feeling lonely or isolated this season due to illness, to quarantine, to the missing of family and loved ones. May we stay safe, may we wear our mask and social distance as needed, and may we pray for those who are ill and for their recovery. This has been a grueling year, but it's a year that leads us into the hope of 2021, and as long as we stay together as the body of Christ, we can overcome anything. So again, we thank you for the light coming into the world, and for the blessing of Christmas year after year. Amen.
Thank you so much, and thank you everybody for coming, and most of all, thank you to all of you who are checking in. May you know the light of Christ in Jesus' holy name, and may you have a very Merry Christmas.